which has been programmed and set up, and at that moment it becomes plugged into the mains and it becomes connected. That's the moment of actualization. That's the moment when you become your spirit. This is what we've been seeking. There's no mesmerism, no intellectual dissertations. It's a reality, and it's happening. It's happening on a mass scale. This is the first time Mataji has been to America since 1972. She came on a visit at that time. But all over the world, Sahaja Yoga, as it's called, is taking root. Thousands upon thousands of people are getting their realization. And when they get it, they're developing it and settling into it. Their life is being transformed. Physical and emotional problems just fall away. You start to feel the joy of life. You can cope with the tensions and stresses of living. And you look at the whole of human existence as almost like a bit of a joke. You cope with the problems in a very wonderful way. The other beautiful thing about self-realization is that as you get it, you can give it to others. One light is enlightened, it can enlighten another light. And this is the way it has to be. It's nothing exclusive, it's nothing that money can buy. And now, as Mother often says, on the tree of life at first there were very, very few flowers that turned to fruit. Now, all the flowers have come, the blossom time has come. And many, many of those flowers have to turn to fruit. And this is the right of the seekers. This is the right which you've earned and which you must pursue. Mother has nothing to gain from this. She travels around the world. She's a mother, she's a grandmother. She's the wife of an important Secretary General of the United Nations, so she has no basis for needing any support of any kind from us. She only gives. And in giving, she's giving nothing but love and compassion. And that's the power of divine love. That's the power of a great spiritual being to awaken that which is within us and which is our right. So during this lecture, simply slip your shoes off and hold your hands out in this fashion so that you take your shoes off so that you can actually become earthed to the earth. That's the purpose. It's as simple as that. It's a very, very basic electrical circuitry.
Unbelievably.
And just simply hold the hands out in that fashion as if asking for something, as if asking for something. It's as simple as that. And what you'll perhaps begin to find is that during the talk, you'll start to feel the vibrations. These vibrations are the vibrations which have been spoken of in all the scriptures. If you're a Christian, it speaks of the cool wind of the Holy Spirit. If you're a Muslim, it's the Ruh, and so it goes on. So again, I'll introduce to you our mother, Mataji Nirmala Devi.
It's really unbelievable, isn't it? It sounds so fantastic. I've been here about 9 years' time. And I told them that it's within you. It's the simplest thing. It's a living process. It works out for nothing at all. It's your own. But what I found, that Americans were still busy guru shopping. They wanted to go through that. They wanted to do all that. What could I do? I told them, you don't have to do all this. Why do you want to waste your energy? Why do you want to waste your money? Nothing, you just have it. But they wouldn't. They wanted to spend their money. They had money that time. They thought they can buy some bhagwans and gods and things like that. All sorts of things were on when I came here. And they wouldn't listen. They wouldn't listen. I said, you cannot purchase it. You cannot buy it. They are misleading you. So I thought better to retire for some time from America. But in India, now in the villages, we have thousands of people who have got energy. It's so simple. You are seekers because the time has come. that you have to be here, and that you have to get your realization. It's very simple. After all, God has created this world, this creation is His own, and He has to save it, jolly well. He has to do it. But it is so incredible, we can't believe it. It's impossible. We think, how can that be? We must stand on our heads, or we have to pay a lot of money, we have to become broke, we have to give up this, give up that, do all sorts of nonsensical things, and then what we find? We are left high and dry. It's true, I know, it's true. But you could have avoided it. When I came here, I told people very, very clearly and plainly. But I was amazed also, apart from this, they did all kinds of funny things about what I announced to them. Like I said that you have to be born again, all right. They taped me, they did everything, and they started organizations with this name, that we are born again. They certified them. And they started another organization with some vibrations, something, some, I don't know. I mean, instead of being honest to yourself and getting the thing down to earth, I didn't know why they were getting into these hallucinations and these imaginary things. We have to be just honest to ourselves, that's all. It's so simple, it's extremely simple. But when you go to these places and do that, you get damaged. You really get damaged. Of course, the task is very difficult now for me, I find. Comparatively, it would have been much better, no doubt. I tell you, it would have been much better. But they wouldn't listen to me. Even up to the point that they said, you must charge some money. People are doing it for so much. At least charge some money that people will have no value for it. I said, if they start valuing it in money, they will never value it. It should not be done. Whatever is wrong should not be done. And they just wouldn't accept it. See, it's such a funny situation. And that's how I went back. For 9 years I waited. But Americans are great citizens, you know. I must say they are. Despite all these damages and all that, we had a very good experience the other day with all these people were there. Especially, we went to Boston, where there were about 54 people or so, and 50 of them got realization just like that. 50 of them, can you believe? I was amazed. It's expanding. Consolidation may be a problem, but that should be consolidated. I did give realization to some here, and they were quite funny. They started charging people for their vibration. I mean, just imagine. They got it without any payment or anything, but they started charging people for it. And when they came to India, we found out they had lost their vibrations. They were very heated up people. And we told them, you cannot charge for it. How do you charge? He said, how are we to live? I said, how did you live before? Live like that? Oh, we were school teachers, we were this. I said, do that. You cannot charge for these vibrations. These are divine, this is love, you cannot charge. How can you sell love? Can you sell your love? It's a simple thing Americans have to understand that you cannot sell. It's too simple for them to understand that there could be someone who really loves. Just loves for love's sake. There could be one at least like that in this world. If they understand this, then it will be easy for them to understand that all these things are built in you. You are already made like that. It's not at all difficult, like a candle which is made properly and there's a way. And it's very easy to enlighten that if you are enlightened. What do you do? What goes out of this candle is nothing. You just enlighten the another life without any difficulties. It's nothing special, nothing great, it's very, very simple. But we want to make everything complicated, then what am I to do? If you have to eat your food, you eat like this, isn't it? Do you put your hand around like that? If you have to breathe, which is so vital, it is the simplest. Do you go to libraries to read how to breathe? It's all so simple you won't believe, like sprouting a seed. It's a living process, has to be simple, spontaneous, has to be simple. How can it be complicated? Then another problem is that here people read a lot about God, read. You can't read about Him, you have to know it. See, they just read, this is the God, that is the God. And we meet somebody, today we met somebody who said that, I believe in a man who calls himself Jesus. I said, very good, put him on the water. Can he walk on the water? If he can walk on the water, all right, he's Jesus. But does he walk? Put him on the water. I mean, it's very simple. If I say, if I am something, I must prove it, isn't it? Now somebody says, I can make you fly. You start paying him money, such a lot of money goes to this fellow. Make him fly. Does he fly? If he flies, then he can teach you. If he does not know himself to fly, how will he teach you? It's a very logical thing. We have to know that we are not going to fly anymore. Now we have flown as birds. So we are not going to fly or hop. We have been there. We are going to become something more in our awareness. This is a simple thing we should know, that we have to become that. Something in our own awareness, something has to happen that should make us something that we are, that we should become the absolute. We are not what we are. We are something else. We are like our, say, mind. We are our rationality, which can go anywhere. It's not absolute. Supposing somebody comes here, Mr. XYZ, and he says, this is a very nice club. Another one will come and say, oh, it's not so nice. Another one say, maybe good, maybe. Three human beings, all of them are human beings. They are not animals, they are human beings, three of them. From the same place, from the same village, you can take it. Put them together, they will have three opinions. If they continue to have that, we shall say three, they can have even 1,000, if they change. So why? Because they have not got their absolute values. There must be something absolute within us when it starts manifesting. You start feeling the absolute. As he said, really it happens to you. You become that in no time, and you can feel it on your hands, on your fingers, the reality. You ask a simple question, is there God? Somebody told me, I don't believe in Christ. I said, all right. Why? Have you seen him? Why don't you believe him? I don't believe. But why? What is the reason? I believe in this and I don't believe in that. But why? Is there any absolute by which you have judged whether there was Christ or not? Whether there was true or not? Whether it's just a myth? No, I have not. Then how can you say, I believe? You keep yourself open. First, you become yourself. That's why Buddha, he said, don't talk of God or anything. First of all, let them become the self. If they become the self, then talk of other things. Because if they do not, if you talk of something else, they will come out with their own ideas. That I don't believe in God, I don't believe in this, I don't believe in that. So he said, all right, you become yourself. That's the first thing. Once you become yourself, then you will start seeing other things through your awareness, which is something special. And that's what should happen to you, is to first become yourself. Then you start judging other things, because now you have that awareness by which you can judge. Now how are we to know that, supposing these vibrations come to us, whether they are also absolute or not? After all, we should find whether they are absolute or not. For that, we can use a method which is, I call, a relative method. Today I told them that you get two boys who are from lunatic asylum, certified magnetic, absolutely certified. All right? Then get two people who have got cancer. And then get two people, one realized soul and one unrealized soul. According to me, they are, one is realized, one is unrealized. All right. Now you put all of them to me and ask them to see their vibrations. You will find the person who is mad. He may start doing all kinds of actions, maybe, or he may feel shaking all over the body, his whole body might shake like this, the whole thing might rattle. The person with the cancer will feel terrible heat getting out of his body and terrible heat coming out of his body. So much so, it happens sometimes, that the room does not need a heater in London, even during winter time. Now, you have another one who is not realized so. Such a person may a little bit feel hot or something, and after some time he starts feeling the cool breeze gradually flowing into him. Then you have realized all a little child's dream. He said, I was getting it when I entered it. Yes, it is there, I know it is there. It's so simple. First it is white. It's important. Evolution is the most important thing. That's how we have become human beings. And you have to become something higher. It is all placed within us very nicely, very safe, very protected. But of course we go headlong into every sort of thing. And naturally we get damaged. With all these beautiful things within us, I see people doing all kinds of nonsensical things, going into all kinds of extremes. There's no need to be in extremes. Somebody comes and tells them, you stand on your head, you'll get to God. They'll go on doing it. I mean, how can you get to God? Use your logic, use your brain. How can you get to God by standing on your head? If it is a living process, if it's absolutely living, then you cannot do anything about it. Because human beings cannot do anything that is happening. Now, at this time, I have told these people who got their realization last time that I will tell them about the Kundalini and its centers and about what they mean. In any case, I hope we have got now books for you also to go through them and see what it is, and you can read them and you can find out about it. But in any case, I will tell you a little bit. Here is the chart. This is the Kundalini here in the triangular bone called a sacrum. Come forward. It will be better. All right. All the new people should come forward.
Plenty of seats.
Yes, please, come forward. Come here. Come forward. Yes, better to come. Yes, please listen. You should be able to see. That's the main part. Yes, come here.
In front.
Let the lady also come here. Come forward. Now, this is not important to know, but I am just telling you how to, because you will have curiosity later on, where is this Kundalini? This Kundalini is placed in the triangular bone here called as sacrum. Now, sacrum means sacred. So the people knew about this, that it is a sacred bone. Now, this bone is placed very securely at the base of the spinal cord. This is kept there as the residual force, but it is the energy of your desire, of becoming one with the divine. It is not yet manifested. That's why it is called as a sleeping Kundalini. Means it has not yet manifested. That power is not yet manifested. Now on the left hand side, this power that is within us is the power of desire. On the right hand side, there is another power, which is the power of our action. Now this is the one which gives us our emotional life, emotional side. This gives rise to the left sympathetic nervous system and is also looking after the psyche, which the psychologists talk about. But most of them, as I said the other day, are half-baked. So they just know about this part of the Kundalini, which they call as the psyche. They know very little, and when they try to do anything about it, they are so unauthorized that they create problems for others and create problems for themselves. They are unauthorized, they have no idea as to what we are, and they just try to meddle with your psyche, creating great problems for you. Now, this is the power of action, which is responsible for our mental and physical efforts, because when we go into action, we put in effort. So this is the area where our future lies, and this is the area where our past lies. Past of our this life, and beyond that is the collective consciousness, a collective subconscious, which is beyond that. Beyond this line is the supraconscious, is the future, and beyond that is the collective supraconscious. These are the areas that are within us. Now, these areas exist within us, and the material side is below, and the health is below that. Now, when we start getting any experience in life, say a person is sitting and suddenly he starts jumping, he thinks, I have got Kundalini awake. How can that be? If there is Kundalini awakening, you are in charge of that. You know you are the master. If you do not know what is happening to you, it is somebody else who is doing the tricks. Maybe you have moved too much onto the left hand side and some spirit has possessed you and he is making you jump. That cannot be any spiritual experience. Spiritual experience is only one, and that is that when you get it, you become master of yourself. Unless and until that happens, one should not accept anything as a spiritual experience. For example, a master, so-called, who lives in Tibet or something, who has died and who is giving experiences. All this is all absurd thing. You are your own master, no doubt, but you have to be made into it. Unless and until you are connected to the means through this, unless and until you are baptized, you are not your spirit. You are to be actually baptized. In the sense, it's a living process, just like a seed sprouts, a seed's primule comes out, the same way this Kundalini has to pass through all these chakras and enter through your fontanelle bone area, awakening this center. It sucks this ego and superego, which is created by these two powers here, superego and ego, and just creating a portion of the head here, which is called as the fontanelle bone area, a very soft and a thin chakra. You can feel the cool breeze of the Kundalini. Now the spirit resides in your heart. Nobody knows, you see. They said, God is in me. Where is he? Where is he placed? He resides in your heart. But you are not aware of it. It is not in your conscious mind. It is not your central nervous system. It knows about you, but you are not conscious of it. When the Kundalini passes through these various centers and pierces through this one, then the seed of the spirit is here, the seed of the spirit. And that's how, when the Kundalini touches that, the seat is informed, like the seat of your government is Washington. Wherever may be the president, if the information goes to Washington, he is informed, like that, this is the seat. And when it informs, the spirit knows about it, and then you start feeling the cool breeze, emitting of the cool breeze in the hand, which is called as he told you, that the cool breeze of the Holy Spirit. Now, some people asked me that, is it cool breeze or hot breeze? You know that when there is any friction, even in the matter, it creates heat. So it has to be cool, but not very cool. It is not very cool. If you become extremely cold, that also means that your left side is all blocked. Now, if there are imbalances in you, like you are too much emotional, then you go more towards this side. And this side is very, very vulnerable. And once you start going too much on that side, there are areas built within you, which are called as collective subconscious. The other day, as I told you, that cancer is caused by the attack of proteins, which are called as protein 58 and all that, because the scientists, you see, they don't know what they are. They come from Visayan. They say it comes from the areas. I mean, the doctors are honest, because whatever they know, that is they say. It comes from the areas which are built within us since our creation. We call it as collective subconscious. We know all about it, because you will yourself see when you get your realization that all these things are there and they attack. This left-sided attack gives you a thing like cancer and many other troubles, like you can say mental problems and schizophrenia and all these things. Right side movement too much, this right side. Where, you see, this of course the psyche people like Mr. Freud, who was really half-baked and a funny person, who said that you should not worry about your, about any conditioning. You should not allow any conditioning upon yourself and do as you like. He didn't know that there is another power within us. If you try to do as you like, then what happens? You start living a life of an ego, ego-oriented. The whole life becomes an ego-oriented. You do not accept any condition, nothing. I'll do as I like, I'll live as I like. I'm a free person. Free doesn't mean license. So I have a license to do what I like. I'm a free person, I can do what I like with myself. And then you start leading a life of ego. Now if you have this left side problem, then the problems attack you, in the sense that you feel depressed, you feel very unhappy, you feel as if the whole world is going to be collapsing on you, and you are extremely receded from life. You become reclusive with this left side. But with the right side, you are riding a very fast horse. We have to say in a way that the people who are, say, very dominating type of people, extremely dominating, who Hitler is the extreme of that. But now Mr. Hitler, if you went and told that you suffer from ego, he would have killed you. He can't bear that. And this kind of a thing, when it comes in you, this ego orientation, is more dangerous, because you harm others and you are not aware of it. So both the things are harmful to you. You have to lead a life of a balance in the center. Now this balance, if you achieve by using these two powers, like the brake and the accelerator, brake and the accelerator within you, you develop that balance. And that balance is achieved, then you lead a very simple, balanced life. But as I said, if somebody comes and tells you, you have to stand on your head, you'll go on standing on your head. If they say, you must have so much of waistline, so much of this thing, they will be jogging throughout. If anything you tell them, they will go to such an extreme end, that either they'll jump on to the right side or to the left side. Now when you go to the left side, the experience can be like you might feel that you are seeing things from somewhere, or you might feel that you are jumping in your bed. The other day I met a man who said that in his dream he saw somebody coming and piercing into his forehead, and since then he sort of immobilized. All sorts of experiences you can get if you go to the left hand side. Some of the drugs that you take you to the left, and some take to the right. Like say LSD, we can say, takes you to the right, by which you start seeing things like an eye you see, and you see colors and things. You go to the supraconscious area. Now this supraconscious area is more dangerous in a way to the seekers than the other side. Because like you get a supraconscious people, you see, who start seeing something written on the wall, they start getting things in their hand, they start prophesizing, and all sorts of things they do. All such people think they have become God. This is a very dangerous situation. They all think they have become, they are held by some busybodies who are making them ESPs. You see, these are actually the busybodies. Like we have one very good example of late Dr. Lack in England. He died, but very ambitious man, and he could not sort of complete his thesis, what he wanted to do about surgery. So his spirit, he being very ambitious, he entered into a soldier who was fighting in Vietnam, can you believe? And this soldier, he didn't enter into his own son, and he told the son, he told this man that you go and see my son in England, and you start a curative center of this late Mr. Lack. I mean, he's dead. And I will help there. You better go and see my son. Now this fellow, in that possessed state, he went to the son. And the son said, all right, how am I to believe that you are my father, that my father is haunting you? He said, I will tell you so many things that we did together secretly. And he was amazed. He said, all right, let's start the thing. And they have got this kind of an institute where if you are suffering from some disease or something, you have to write to that institute. Now what they do, they will tell you at 5 o'clock on such and such date. They are honest, I should say, will enter into your body and cure. They will cure one disease, but because of this extreme push this side, you are again pushed back on the other side, rebounded, and you may develop a horrible nervous system. You might become lunatic, you may become mad. I mean, people who have been his patients are worse patients now, and I have been treating them in India, many of them. So such organizations exist, and they start telling you about many things like, if you go this side, this will happen. I mean, it's a very subtle behavior of these horrible people, these busybodies, and they try really, really to spoil you. Now many of the gurus who come here, the so-called these gurus, are either work on this side or that side, or sometimes both sides. They use the spirits to mesmerize you, first of all. You are just mesmerized. They will use any spirit to introduce in this center, for example, an antichrist will touch this one. And I know of somebody who is here, an antichrist, absolute antichrist. He touches this center and creates problems in you and produces within you a symptom, just like blood cancer. There's another one who wants to teach you to how to fly. He gives you epilepsy, simple thing like epilepsy. There is another one who gives you cancer. There's third one who gives you heart attack. They're experts on giving you diseases. All one better than the other. And in the long run, you find all your money is lost. You are lost. There's nothing left with you. You are a recluse. There's somebody who has made his disciples so funny that they're even afraid of the vegetable, like the garlic. You show them the garlic, they'll run out. If you show them a lemon, they'll run out. So these people have worked on you because you are naive. First of all, you have money. They have no interest in the poor people of India. They have no interest in looking after people who understand them. They have only interest in you who are naive, who are simple people, who have money. And best of all, you are that category which is the seekers. You are born specially to seek yourself. You are a special category. Everybody is not like that. In, say for example, I would say in this place, New York, there may be many seekers, I agree, there could be many seekers. But this category is not with everyone. There are few human beings who are really, relatively to its population, are seekers. And these special categories have to become prophets. And they have to make others prophets, is prophesied by a great poet like William Blake. We should read all these things and understand that this is all, is even Sahaja Yoga is all being prophesied in the Bible. In all the Puranas, in all the books, it is prophesied that in these modern times, this is going to happen. That thousands of people who have been searching God in their previous lives are going to receive their blessings and they are going to become that. Under these promises, you start going to these people, but they cannot give you because they are not authorized. They are not here to give you realization. They are here to make their money. They are parasites. They are absolute parasites. Say now today, as he said, my husband is well-placed, maybe I come from a rich family or whatever it is. I don't have to depend on you or anyone. But supposing I was like Christ, a carpenter's daughter. So I would have lived like that. It makes no difference whether you are rich or poor. It makes no difference to me. Comfort has no meaning, has no meaning. I can sleep here, I can sleep anywhere. Yesterday we went to Boston and it was a small little room of a student. There were 6-7 people, we all slept together. No problem for me. In my house, I have bedrooms, I have everything, it's too much of a comfort. And it falls upon me, I don't like it. So a person who is a holy person doesn't seek others' money and doesn't live like a parasite. For example, you see yourself, if I tell you, I give you money for your living, will you accept any one of you? And these people are doing nothing for their living, they are living on your money, they are having Rolls Royces and this and that. It's a saint has no interest in these things. Like one of them who is nowadays here, who has now become a Yankee, they say, he told to India, to English people, he wrote to them that if you want me to come there, they are all mad after. They said they have got knowledge. What sort of a knowledge God alone knows? That if I am coming to England, you have to give me a Rolls Royce. The poor boys, you see, in England, I mean, as it is, people are not so rich and young people don't have so much money. And they starve themselves, ate potatoes, did this and that, and they created a 59th Rolls Royce for me. He has already 58. This 59th was created and this fellow very nicely came to receive the Rolls Royce. And you ask them, what has he given? If he has given us knowledge, we are in knowledge. Just like possessed people they are moving. And they are going down. Those people who come from that area have mostly blood cancer. They have blood cancer. And they just live as if they are not living. It's such a horrible thing. What knowledge have they got? If you have knowledge, you should know what's happening in another person. You should get collectively conscious. You should become, its actualization should happen to you. You should feel that, as you are shown here, that all the centers you can feel on your fingers. You should feel your own centers and you should feel the centers of others. You should become that. If you are satisfied with what you have done and what wrongs you have done, we cannot cure. You have to know that you have not found it and you have to get to it in all honesty and sincerity. And throw away all that is nonsensical. Then only it works out. And this has to happen to you, that you start feeling all these centers here. Now see, you can see the colors that are given separately onto this. Now for example, this is the left hand. And left hand means the left side. Left side of this one. Now this one, if it is catching, if you feel heat, if you feel any catching, if you feel that there's burning in this finger, in this thumb of left hand, this is all, left side is the psyche. Means somebody has tried to disturb your psyche in an unauthorized way. Most of the gurus have this. All the left side can be caught up by them. But especially this one is a sign that you have been to somebody who has been unauthorized. Anyone, you can go to a spiritualist. It's a most dangerous game to have spiritualists. I was surprised somebody told me, Mother, you are going to America now, they have started witchcraft also. Imagine. They told me it's much worse now. It was better 10 years back, now it's witchcraft. You'll be facing people who are doing witchcraft, they're doing all openly. And I mean, they warned me that maybe you may not be able to do anything there, but I don't think so. It's much better than I expected and I'm very happy about it. So this is what happens to you, is that when you start doing something like that, you start showing. Now this one is this side, left side of this very important center. This one shows that you are guilty, you feel guilty, you are diffident. When the spirit approaches this point, it makes you all the time feel guilty. You feel guilty for everything. What is there to feel guilty? I mean, you have not murdered anyone. Real murderer will never feel guilty. But the one who has done nothing all the time starts saying, oh, I should not have said this, I should not have done this, I should not have gone there. All these feelings come to you from left Vishuddhi. It can be from the kind of training you have had. For example, mostly as in Catholics, because they have to go and confess. Even if they have done no sins, they have to go and confess because the priest must have his existence somehow. So, this kind of a thing you have had, that you have to go and confess some sort of a sin, you may even coin of your own because you don't know what to talk to him if you have not committed any sins in the week. So all these things are settled out. You must know all the sins and all the blasphemy, everything that you have done is going to be forgiven, has to be forgiven. If it is going to be our mass realization, all these things have to be forgiven. It's written. I was reading the other day Pilgrim's Progress and he has said that all these things will be forgiven. It's promised. And what sin can you commit? What guilt can you have? If God is ocean of forgiveness and love, what can you do? He is going to cleanse you. He is going to cleanse you. He has to do. So what's the use of feeling guilty all the time? But that doesn't mean you should feel arrogant on the other side. This side you feel guilty, and right side, if you have on the right side the cash, that means you have been very much aggressive. Or you may be suffering from cold or all these things. These are suggestive of physical side. The right side is for physical and mental side. All these things you can verify gradually. I would suggest that you should get your realization first. First thing first. Let's open your eyes, let you have the light within yourself and see for yourself how it works. All right? Should we have that? And also we'll have some questions. Can I have some water? You're already feeling it. You are feeling guilty now. Yes, that's true, you are already feeling it.
Yes.
This is a very common disease in the West. To feel guilty is a very common disease. We Indians never feel, you know. Indians are really never feel guilty. They have other things, but not this. Thank God. And they have many other problems, terrible ones. Unbelievable. All right? Is it all right? Coming. Is it all right?
Good.
You got his realization, brother. Are you all right? Are you feeling? Good. But see, I was telling you, we don't know how to advertise. I mean, we've done our level best. But people don't come to reality. You have one mesmerizer here, all of them straightforward. This room won't be such. We tried everything. I don't know how to reach to the seekers. I mean, I don't know what they are seeking. They want all the circus. I don't know what they want. So, any questions?
Any questions at all?
Yesterday I told you, that day I told you about Christ, isn't he, when he is awakened. I told you that? You were there for the lecture? When he is awakened here, that the ego and superego are sucked in. That is what is promised, that he is the one who sucks ego and superego, but he is to be awakened. First thing that happens when Kundalini rises, that you find there is no thought in your mind. There's no thought. You have become blank. First thing. Then when it pierces through, you start feeling the cool breeze. It's so simple. You can't believe it. You don't know. There was a gentleman who came to me, he's an actor in London. He came in a program, and when he got it, he laughed and he couldn't bear it. He said, Mother, I'll go out and laugh now aloud. He went around and laughed. I said, but why did you laugh so much? He said, I did all kinds of acrobats. That's why I was laughing. It's so simple. Imagine. People have written books after books and so much damn nonsense they have done, I tell you. Can't imagine. All trash. Are you all right now? Better? Better?
Thank you.
Still. All right, now you go on saying I'm not guilty in your heart. Put your right hand on your heart. Yes, now.
Okay, I'm not guilty.
No, again. Say it thrice.
Yeah, I'm not guilty on my heart.
Again?
I'm not guilty on my heart.
All right?
It's stupid. But I could have slept wrong,
so.
Because last night I was...
We'll work it out, but you just say I'm not guilty. Yeah. This is, you have put your own load here. Better now, see? Remove it.
I'm not guilty on my heart.
Huh?
No, it's... Well, if you, I turn, it hurts. But it's... I feel the heat here.
It is little there, but it's better now, gradually. How many years you have been feeling guilty?
Just about a year.
It will work out.
Yes, okay. When you say the realization, is it a connection that you want us to achieve or to understand between the spiritual, in other words, the connection of the spiritual?
Of course, yeah. It's a breaking through. Uh-huh. You become that. It's the connection is established. Uh-huh. Like every instrument has a connecting line, isn't it? You have to connect it to the maze. You are just to be connected to the maze. That's fantastic, see. For example, now, you have a camera or say you have a television or something like that. If you connect it to the mains, it starts showing its fantastic things. You are like that. Nothing so fantastic. You are fantastic, but you have no self-esteem. I don't understand. Human beings have no self-esteem. I mean, they are top of all the evolution. They are higher than all the animals. Now they are learning the behavior from animals. We have nothing to learn from them. Have we to learn anything from them? God has placed us so much above. Yes, my child.
Why are we separated from that spirit, and are we at birth?
We are separated because of ignorance. You see, we started becoming from amoebic stage to human stage, you see, developing our awareness better and better and better. Like a reflector we are, you see. So the reflector is improving gradually, and the reflection of that spiritual life shows better and better till we reach a human stage. Now here we come at this stage, is a process, is a living process, you see. And then this, we become connected and that ignorance is finished. We are not separated as such. We are looked after. Like there is darkness in this room. But you are not separated from light. Only you have to switch off. There is no punishment or anything done to you. No. Because you have come from that. Your awareness has started improving.
Does this happen? You keep talking about the living process, and does this happen? This can happen while you're alive, but does it happen when you die, or not necessarily?
No, not. You have to live. You have to have a body. If you don't have a body, this realization doesn't take place. So some people talk of the dead gurus and all that is not possible. You have to get it when you are living. You have to have the body. Body is the temple. As you can say that if there is no bulb, you cannot get light. There may be light, but you have to have a bulb. It has to come in the form of a human being, not in the animals. Yeah?
May I ask, you mentioned here that you are the link of self-realization. So are we, or the people who get self-realization here, getting the self-realization through you, or
through yourself? Did they say, I am the me?
Yes.
You should not have said that. It means that, you see, I am the one who enlightens, that's all. As one lighter, you can enlighten also. They should not have said that, it's dangerous to say such a thing. You see, because if it says everybody's ego comes up like that, oh God, she is, who is she? You see, everywhere, mostly, I have seen in Europe especially. They said, why you? I said, you do it. I'll be very happy. I'm a happily wise woman. I have a very good husband, my children and grandchildren. All right? I have to do it day in and day out. If you can do it, nothing like it, I will return. If you can do it, nothing like it, you see. To travel like this, work it out, spend your own money, do it. It's not. Mostly I must be something special in God. But that you find out later on, not just now. Alright? I have to be something special to do. But that you find out later on. You should not have put it in there. Because half of Americans would not come if they say there is somebody who is a link. Because they all think they are already realized souls, great people dropping from heaven. This is also another kind of a self-esteem.
Well, do you just have to want it, or how do you get it?
Me. Yeah, I think we'll discover it later on because I never got it. I had it. That's the problem.
Then she's asking, does she just have to want it herself?
Does one have to want it, or does one just all of a sudden?
There is one thing,
see it.
That it cannot be forced. You see, your freedom is respected. Now you are free. Now, if the egg wants to be bird or not, you don't ask the egg. You don't ask. Because it's animal stage. But in human stage, you have to ask for it. If you do not ask, you do not get it. Nobody is going to force on you. Neither the divine is going to fall at your feet that you ask. No. On the contrary, you have to humble down to ask for it. It cannot go to arrogant people. You have to ask for it, in a way. If it works, thank your stars. If it doesn't work, we'll work it out later. But you have to ask for it, no doubt. It's such a great thing. Only that much you have to do. Not pay for it, but ask for it. In a humble way. Yes?
Something disturbing about the movements, and not yours, I'm just saying, but you mentioned before that there are so many seekers in the United States today and so forth. I find it very disturbing to find that these people are seeking divinity or spirituality, and yet they themselves are not in a state of purification or do not live in a pure state.
I agree.
And I don't see how the two can reconcile each other. I mean, I think before you realize this realization, this
connection, you must go into a cleaning process.
Yes, exactly. And really to have these desires that are vulgar and so forth fall away from you.
No,
shouldn't,
you see, this was done before, see, and it's a very slow process. Which was worked out, that you try to cleanse yourself, but not possible. Unless and until there's a realized guru who looks after you, each individual and all that. Now, the grace has decided that first of all, let us start all the machines, all the cars, you can say second hand, third hand, fifth hand. Let us start to see how far they go. Then try to correct. Unless and until you get out of your car, also you do not know what's wrong with you. So unless and until you get your realization, really you cannot. Say for example now, I am an old ancient guru of olden times. Take it like this. Now you come to me. First of all, these gurus used to test you. They would make you stand on your head, stand on your legs and do all kinds of things. Because they would take only one person. One person among millions. And see that if they could work it out and they would really work on him and make him do all those things and everything. Now the trouble is, in modern times, if you tell anybody to do something, they'll do just the opposite. It's a very difficult situation. Now think from a mother's point of view. I want you to have your realization because I can't enjoy it myself. You have to have your. I can see that diamond in you. I want you to have. So what would mother do? If she has to do something, she'll go around and say, all right, let's have it. First you have it and see if you like it or not. Supposing I have cooked the food and you say, no, I don't want to have it. So what will I say? All right, you taste a little bit. See how it is. Once you jump into it, for these people I've got now, he's got realization. He knows the taste of it. Not only that, but without realization you can't judge yourself. If I judge you, I say, no. Supposing I say, Warren, you have lots of ego. When he came to me, he was ego like a balloon like this. He won't believe. But if I tell him that, he would have punched me immediately, isn't it? Oh, you agree there, isn't it? But this fellow, I didn't say to him, you have ego or anything. All right, I said, we'll give you realization. Then he came down on it. Then, you see, I put him into proper state, raised his kundalini. Then he started seeing his ego. He said, oh God, what the ego has, mother? Now what to do with it? I said, well, I'll tell you how to do it. So, unless and until you have the eyes you can't see, and if you tell them don't do it, you will do it. So best thing is to give the eyes first to you. You may not see it so clearly, but you'll start seeing it. Alright? Then you will start improving yourself. You'll judge yourself. You better judge yourself is much better than I judge you. Then you correct yourself because you can't just bear it. Yesterday there was a lady, she was suffering from liver. She's not come today. And she told me, mother, after realization I got a headache. I said, good, you have a liver? Otherwise you would not attend to it. But now you've got a headache, you better attend to it. So I told her how to look after it. And within 2 days she's all right. She's cured. People become mad and they don't know they are possessed. Till they absolutely land up in the lunatic asylum. So, to give them judgment power is very important. And how will you make out one is a real guru or not a real guru? Even logically you can, but otherwise. How will you make out? Very simple, you just see it with the vibration. So you must get your discrimination power. But actually while getting it, you really become the master. That's the simple thing. Now he has been with me only for 18 weeks, can it be 18 months? 18 months only, now he is a master. He has established 7 centers in 7 cities in Australia and he's come to America, I mean imported him. For you people. But now you better go and look after other people. What's the question?
You were talking about the spirit being in the heart chakra there over on the left side. I'd like to know why it's on the left instead of in the middle. Because if the spirit has to do with realization, why isn't it in the middle and the central kundalini instead of on the inside like that? And why is it and why
in
is
the
it
heart?
There? Yeah.
Heart is the main thing within us, you see, that's the last. Once heart stops, we don't exist, it's sheer existence. That's the most important organ God has given. Once the spirit is angry, in any way strained, any way despaired, we just disappear. And then we die. There's nothing left. Heart is very important. That's why he's placed. In human beings, but it comes out. It comes out also. It can come out and see, go around and see you. But the seed is when you will start going into Sahaja Yoga, you will start seeing how the spirit manifests and how it grows, and it sits on the seat also.
Isn't both
one? It is now in the heart, but then it comes on the seat at a point. That's much different, that's much later.
Oh, I see.
All right? So it has to be brought there. First, a seat has to be created properly. Just now, heart is the one seat he likes, it's there. You see, it is not according to our whim, it is his whim that is important. So we have to please his whims also.
Would you say conscience and soul reside in the heart area?
What is it?
Conscience. In other words, people, their guilt feelings or their realization of what's right and wrong resides in the heart feeling. It comes from the heart area.
Not that. Knowledge. It doesn't come. It's come from the left side, as I showed you. But heart area is the one where resides the spirit, actually.
So the soul would be?
Soul. And the soul is a wider thing than spirit is. Because when one dies, only the element, that is the mother element, or the earth element, dies. Mm-hmm. And the water element also starts getting oozing out. But whatever remains are the other three elements, you see, which has the three auras, plus the spirit is the soul. And the Kundalini also resides on that. After realization, you can see that. You can see it in the... So many, you can see so many Kundalinis floating. They have all seen it. You see, it's fantastic. Yes, it's fantastic. You are all fantastic people.
That's not the aura necessarily.
No. Auras are right side, supraconscious. But you actually see these Kundalinis floating around. I'll show you. All right? So what is it now?
How do we do this for us?
Huh?
How do we do this for ourselves?
All right, that's the point. We are coming to that point now, all right? And have some water. Oh, you should not have put missing link or something. Did you put missing link or what?
No.
Don't say all that.
Not the missing
link. You think too much.
If it offends you, get your realization first and
not offends, but it offends everyone, I think. You see, because we should learn from our experience, I think. Christ said nothing except that. He said, I am the Son of God. And they crucified him. One has to be careful. If you say anything like that, people don't like it. Better not. Tell them, I'm just like you, blind. Little my eyes are open. Then they'll be happy. It was very wrong to say that. I didn't see that. I would have told you. I'm anxious not to say.
It seems to imply that we're getting your realization. The realization through you, that you are the link to the eternal.
Well, why will you have objection to that?
I beg your pardon?
Will you have objection if it is so?
Well, it would be your realization that we are tasting. Because you would be the link.
Supposing I will take a supposition, then what's harm? What is the harm?
Really no harm, but there's a price for everything.
No, it should not. Because you must know that I'm conscious, can't talk to you. Somebody has to come and talk. Somebody has to decode. Somebody has to tell. It's not easy to become human being, you know. It's very difficult for the divine to become human. It's absolutely, I tell you, it's such a hazardous thing to become a human being. Because they are so absurd, so stupid, and you don't know what to do with it. It's a very difficult task. I'm shocked sometimes. How can they do it? I mean, I just can't understand.
For the divine to become a human being, she's saying, for the divine to become...
It's a very difficult thing. You see, divine to be divine is the easiest thing. But to become a human being, to talk to them, to look after them. You see, for supposing if I am divine, right? If you insult me, you'll be hurt. And that I won't like, because I'm compassionate. Like Christ said, forgive them, for they do not know what they're doing. For the Jews, you see, that's for the Jews. For they do not know what they are doing, because he was frightened. They are crucifying him, and he was frightened for the people, because he was compassionate. It's a very difficult situation. Very sensitive. But you should not have put that. I think it was a mistake. I never saw that. It's a good pointing out. You see, I know it, people won't like it. They won't like it. I think our second one is a better one. Who did that?
Oh, it was done. It was done for the Australian tour, Mother.
Oh, Australians are very different from Americans. You should never have done from America. No. Australians are very different people, you see, because they were punished once upon a time, their forefathers. So they do not have ego trips, much. Mm. They do not have. They want a redeemer. They are very different type of people. Here, people think they are redeemers of the whole world. In Americans, think they are the redeemers of the whole world, you know, they are responsible for everything. This is a very different land. You should have never done that. Yes, it's a very common thing. I mean, Americans really think they are going to redeem the whole world. And all the antichrists are coming and settling down with them. All the antichrists are, as a result. And it's such a dangerous situation that I just pray that they will have more sense to understand these are antichrists. Throw them away!
Explain what you mean by the manifestation. How does how do you see an antichrist? What does he manifest as?
He's a devil. He's a satan.
You know why? As a person, it wouldn't affect me. It wouldn't bother me if I see something as what you call evil. I don't consider things evil per se, but
for this, I would just say you get your realization, then you will know how much it bothers you, because you don't see it. Then. If you don't see a snake, how will you know how it acts?
Yeah, no, but I mean, as a person that doesn't like whatever is unrealized or something, you reject it. Why is it so effective as a
because it
harmful attitude?
Because it kills all your chances of realization, mm-hmm. First and foremost. I don't mind if they're thugs, they take away money from you, make you poor, do what they like. I don't mind all that. Let them be parasites, do anything. I mean, there are so many people like that, isn't it? There are so many beggars, there are so many parasites in this world, there are so many thugs, and there are so many thieves, and there are murderers, every sort. I don't mind anything of that kind. But because they spoil your kundalini, that's why I have all the objections. You have to have your realization, that's your right.
And then you shrug it off. I mean, it doesn't affect you if you have...
No, my child, that's not.
No, you shrug off. She's asking, do you shrug off all the negativity?
Yeah, the negativity, that's what I mean.
Who shrugs?
She's asking, does one, when they get their realization, shrug off the negativity?
Oh, after realization? Or they just run away?
That's what I'm saying, that when you see this, you just, that's why I mean, people...
But a person who is not a realized soul, according to me, is not yet fully a person. Mm. You see? That's what I'm trying to tell you, that you are not yet fully that, you have to become that. Now the gentleman is getting very, very
impatient,
and that should be so, because now let us not too much go into mental activity, you see, because what will happen, you may not get your realization if mental activity, because this center goes into it. So, but let us stop at this point, let's have it, all right? Let's have the mat. Now you have to take out your shoes, I'm sorry, because that helps the mother up to take away her problems. We must get our realization at any cost. That's the main thing. It's my only thing is that you must get your realization. What's that?
Just a tape recorder.
He's taping it?
Could be
danger. We don't allow them to tape. So with the taping, they started a lot of organizations this time.
Would you mind if it...
No, at all. Okay.
Right? If you want to have tapes, you can have from these people. They have got some tapes of my speeches. But normally we don't allow people to tape, because last time's experience was so horrifying that this time we have decided not to allow people who are not Sahaja Yogi to tape. But if you want to have tapes, you can have from these people.
Okay.
Have I tested?
Yes.
Yes. Now, it's all on the left hand. It's working out. It's all right. Now, let's have your hands towards me and close your eyes. Right? Put both the feet on the ground. Both the hands towards me. And close your eyes. Don't open your eyes. Because when the Kundalini gushes through your the center of Agya, then there is dilatation of the pupil. And if you keep your eyes open, it won't come up. Close your eyes. This happening takes place and your attention is drawn inside. Now you put your right hand on your heart, please, again. Right? Close your eyes. Now ask a question to me. Mother, am I the spirit?
Mother,
am I the spirit?
Three times. Mother,
am I the spirit?
Again.
Mother, am I the spirit?
Now say, Mother, I am not guilty.
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 Now, you have to ask for realization. Say, Mother, please give me my realization.
Mother, please give me my realization. Mother, please give me my realization. Mother, please give me my realization.
Now please say, Mother, I forgive everyone. What is it?
Mother,
I forgive everyone. Again, say it.
Mother, I forgive everyone.
Again.
Mother, I forgive everyone.
Now you have to say, Mother, if I have neglected my spirit, please forgive me.
Mother,
if I have neglected my spirit, please forgive me.
Mother, if I have neglected my spirit, please forgive me. So you can see now. You got it?
Just put your right hand. Mm-hmm. Yes, he has that. Good. Just put your right hand over here.
You got it. You can feel it on your head if you have got it. All the surgeons can come and see.
Feel it there? Coming out of the top of your head? You feeling it there?
Those who have been to other gurus put should say, Mother, I am my own guru.
I can feel his.
You can.
Yes, you can feel.
He's got it.
She knows.
I don't even have to feel it.
Are you feeling it on your hands?
It's coming all out of you.
Yes, he's got it. All right. Have you got it? You didn't say anything. You were keeping quiet. You should have said it. You are catching on the Vishuddhi. And if you had said it, it would have opened up. All right, we'll get it. You should get it.
Yeah.
All right, we'll work it out. David, let's see.
It's a different sort of feeling. It's a totally different sensation.
Now are you feeling it?
It's a very specific, like a little one draught.
Slowly. It's a very subtle thing. You see, it's very subtle.
One draught.
But in the second shot, it is better, isn't it? More clear. It's very clear.
Yeah.
Oh, it's hot. All right. You're all right now, are you?
I can't tell them. It's a pity that they can't turn the air conditioning. The air conditioning is causing a lot of disturbance.
No, it's all right. You see, you believe it is there. Just, you see, somebody who got it in
right.
He went.
Well,
he thought that the window was open, you see.
You can lock
and then he went into the then he went into the cellar to see. And still it was there. Are you all right now? Good.
It's true, because...
I'm very happy the second sitting
right
in front.
Yes,
it's good. So change. Look at this gentleman. Are you all right now? Good. See, you've got it. Second sitting, you've got it. Now what about this gentleman? Just you've got it? Yes, go and see. Go and see him. Did you feel my child? No?
She's feeling it in her left, but not in her right. She fixed her left.
That's why I said the doctor said, start to go out here. Now you have to forgive. Won't forgive. I forgive.
How is it? I forgive.
Okay.
I forgive.
Okay.
I forgive.
I forgive everyone.
I forgive everyone.
Forgive.
Oh, forgive me,
it's not there. Now forgive.
It's an indication, you see, of which chakra is. Or aren't you feeling it?
See?
Don't believe it. Don't try and trick yourself. You either feel it or you don't.
It's
not something you have to believe, no way. Cold, but you can't feel it all. As if not.